C++ standard doesn't force any particular way the virtual functions should be implemented. However, C++ compilers like MSVC, Clang, or GCC implement the virtual functions using the virtual method table, the approach which I'm going to explain in this video. When a class implements a virtual function, the compiler is going to create a virtual table, VTable for short. This table is just a simple array that contains addresses of the virtual functions that the class implements or derives. Let us take a look at this class. Here we have two virtual functions, func_a and func_b, along with one non-virtual function, func_c. The virtual table is going to contain only addresses of virtual functions, in this example, func_a and func_b. When a class has a virtual table, the compiler will add an additional, hidden member, called virtual table pointer, at the beginning of the memory layout. As the name suggests, it points to a virtual table of the class the object is created from. In this example, let's see what happens when one class derives from the other class, which already has a virtual table. In that case, the compiler is going to copy the content of base class virtual table and replace overridden functions from derived class. If derived class implements additional virtual functions, they are going to be placed at the end of the current virtual table. Because func_b wasn't overridden, it's going to contain base class func_b function address. As you can see, the offsets to corresponding functions within tables stayed the same. There is also a case where a class can have more than one virtual table. This happens when we derive from two different base classes which already have at least one virtual table. In this example, there are going to be two virtual tables for derived class. Depending on the inheritance order, the first one is going to be related to base class A and second one to base class B. Similar to the previous example, the content of both virtual tables is going to be copied into the corresponding virtual tables. Next, the overridden functions are replaced. New virtual functions are going to be merged with the first virtual table. In the case of inheritance, the corresponding virtual tables are going to be placed at the beginning of each base class object inside derived class memory layout. When we execute the virtual function using a pointer, like in this example, dynamic dispatch is used. First, we're going to check a virtual table pointer which locates virtual table. Then, we get the function address from that virtual table which we can use to call the function. Depending on the class the object was created from, the virtual table is going to differ and different function might be executed. The last piece of the puzzle is to talk about how virtual table pointer is set up. The constructor is responsible to fill this pointer before user-defined logic is executed. If there is a base class, like in this example, its constructor will first set up base class virtual table, and then the user-defined constructor for the base class can proceed. After base class constructor finishes, the derived class virtual table is filled in, and the user-defined logic can now be executed. Notice in this example that even though getMemberA is overridden by derived class, inside base class constructor, the original function is going to be used. This is to prevent a situation where overridden function inside the constructor would try to access data that hasn't been initialized yet. Now you know how virtual functions are implemented in C++. Hope you guys learned something new and interesting today. If you have any comments or questions related to this topic, don't hesitate to ask in the comment section.